It is another edition of the Daily Grossi. Chris Olak and our Browns analyst Tony Grossi alongside me. As you can see, Tony standing live outside the Berea headquarters for the final day of practice this week before we turn our attention to the Cowboys next week. So let's dive into it. Plenty to get to today, but let's start with one of the newest captains on the team, Denzel Ward. So practice today. He spoke with the media first time since suffering his fifth concussion of his career. Tony, just give us some of your biggest takeaways from Ward today, and especially his playing status for next week.
He said he's fine. He's good to go. He's unconcerned with any lifetime effects of his five concussions so far. He will switch to a newer helmet. They keep coming out with new helmets to help guard against concussions, and he will wear that helmet, he said. The thing about it is, you know, the incidence of concussions with Ward is now five, but, you know, he was out 2 weeks with this through this protocol process. And he said the new research shows that if you return, if you give your brain time to heal from that traumatic, you know, hit, you're good to go when you go back in. That's why these guys are out 2 weeks in protocol.
Sure.
And that's one of the reasons he's very encouraged and very optimistic that there will be not the long-term effects of players who suffered concussions in the 70s and 80s, even the 90s. So he pointed that out to us, and it makes a lot of sense. You know, we see a guy get dinged and he's out for 2 weeks, and you wonder, boy, that must be serious. No, they're waiting for the brain to totally heal. And that's why he feels good about going back in.
What does being voted a captain mean to him?
First time ever for him. I asked him, were you a captain at Ohio State? No. He's very proud of that. He said he considered himself a captain from the moment he walked into this team. But, you know, I've talked a lot about how he has kind of mentored MJ Emerson. And Denzel, in his seventh year, has really grown into the role of a team leader. And he said having the C now on his chest is not that big of a deal, considering he's felt he's been a leader all along. The other captains voted by the players, special teams will be Charlie Hewlett again. Defense, along with Denzel Ward, is Miles Garrett. And on offense, it's Joel Bitonio and Deshaun Watson. So they have five captains going into the season. Those are season captains. I'm sure there will be those separate game captain for the coin toss, but he's really proud of the fact that he's gotten to this point in his career.
So Hewlett, Ward, Garrett, Bitonio, Watson, your five captains. Okay. Elsewhere practice today, we're starting to get a little bit of a clearer picture, potentially at left tackle, the starting left tackle for the Cowboys. What can you tell us?
Well, it's continuing to be, Jack Conklin. I watch, you know, we're only allowed to watch like 15 minutes of practice, and I focused on the offensive line. And although they weren't in a team set, he was lining up with his left hand on the ground, every piece of individual drills there. So I believe this is going to be a extreme positive to have a healthy Jack Conklin at left tackle and DeJuan Jones at right tackle. So it's really turned what was a big problem all summer long into, as long as he could stay on the field, a pretty good strength, I believe.
Yeah. Still no sign of Jed Wills on the field, correct?
No, he did not practice. There was a new DNP. It was defensive tackle Quentin Jefferson, but it's nothing major. Of course, Denzel was practiced today. It was a longer practice than we expected. Because, you know, they are off now for the next 3 days. And then they did announce the captains right after practice. So that kind of strung things out a little bit.
Okay. So anything else from practice that is noteworthy?
Not from practice, but we did visit with Catherine Raich, the assistant to Andrew Berry, assistant GM, one of two assistant GMs to Berry. And I asked her point blank, you know, the widely reported that the Browns struck a deal with the 49ers for Brandon Ayuk and also had a contract worked out with them. Is that true or false? And she politely declined to answer that. and talked around it pretty much. That answer kind of told me that is they probably did have a deal locked up with Brandon Ayuk, and he chose not to accept it.
So the reason we're bringing up Brandon Ayuk again is because this morning the Browns made a ton of cap space with Deshaun Watson's contract, restructuring it again, in essence, kicking the can down the road in terms of paying him all the money and the cap hit and all of that. Just kind of sum up what that means and what the move to restructure Watson's deal means for the team going forward.
Okay, so the Browns, by doing that, the Browns lead the league right now in cap room of about $60 million, give or take a few million. $60 million, and the appearance is, boy, they're creating that room for something, a big splash. Well, not so. If you look further, you know, next year, there are existing contracts for next year already, and the Browns were about $60 million over next year's projected cap without adding any players. So Andrew Berry is always proactive, always looking a year, 2 years ahead. And he knows he's going, if he did nothing, he would have to restructure several contracts next year and maybe even make some player cuts to get under the cap. This year he's proactive, so he's created this cap room, and he'll probably use some of it, you know, for things that happen during the year.
Sure.
And at the end of the year, he'll roll it into next year, and it'll make next year's contract tasks a lot easier. So that's why, that's how I view what they did with Watson, is to kick the can with other contracts in mind, not just Deshaun's. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it doesn't necessarily result in a big move this year,
right.
But it just made more sense to, I'm paraphrasing you now, rather than nickel and diming here and there, just go from the one big contract, renegotiate it, and you roll it over. So, in essence, and Tony Rizzo asked you this on the Really Big Show today, the idea of doubling down on their faith in Watson, and I actually had the same thought, because there was talk of, well, if Watson plays bad this year, you only got to worry about the contract, you know, for two more years, and you might be able to wiggle your way out of it. But in essence, because of his cap, what the cap hit will be next year for Watson, specific to next year, virtually untradeable, correct?
Yeah. And, you know, first of all, let me just state, he's getting no new money. He's getting, the money's the same. It's just he's getting it in advance rather than wait for week by week. It is kind of a further commitment to him, though, because you're right. I mean, even if things go sour this year, there's no way out of this. The cap ramifications would be horrendous. And so Andrew is borrowing, so to speak, on Watson's contract, encouraged that he's going to be their quarterback for at least the next 3 years, this year and the 2 years remaining on his contract. So to me, it is a doubling down on their commitment to him and using his contract to create the space for other things.
Just quickly, a couple other roster notes. The Browns cut Tyler Huntley after trying to find a trade partner, unable to do it. Running back Deontay Foreman back. Any real surprises with either move?
No. You know, I think the key factor in the Tyler Huntley release was that the L.A. Chargers traded for Taylor Heinicke. They needed a backup quarterback, and they thought with Greg Roman there, who had been the coordinator with Baltimore for a while when Huntley was there, that Huntley might have had an advocate with the Chargers, but they went elsewhere. And after that, there just wasn't much of a market for Tyler Huntley.
All right, Tom, off Friday, off Saturday, off Sunday, off Monday.
No. I've been.
Did things change?
They do come back Monday. It's really the first week. And then Tuesday's the regular day off. So,
okay. So they did change it. Okay.
I think I was incorrect in stating they were having 4 days off in a row. It was always known that they were going to get Tuesday off anyway. So they're coming back Monday. It's a day of work, and it's really the beginning of the season on Monday.
Tony, enjoy the final weekend with no NFL football. It's going to be a fun ride. Enjoy the weekend, and we'll catch up again on Monday.
Hope we have some golf weather this weekend.
Let's hope so. Thank you, Tony.
All right. Thanks, Chris.